to see another year of the DMC. And before we get back into some cutting and scratching, I just want to say how proud I am of an old student of mine. I met this guy when he was like, I don't know, he had to be like a good 16, 17 years old. His teacher came to one of our X-Ecutioners show. Her name's Michelle, and she was like, hey, I got this one student, you know, I didn't know her. She was like, I got this one student that I'm worried about. I don't want him to get in trouble. And I just feel like he gravitates to you, Rob. You should come teach a class at the high school. And I went to the high school and did like a performance for like Black History Month. And the kid, the one kid that Michelle wanted me to meet, ended up challenging me to a battle at this Black History Month thing. And then I had to burn him on the stage. And what's crazy is now he could burn me and Mr. Sinista. Make some noise for DJ Precision the Head. Bring him out, man. Bring him out. Bring him out. Just watch the court, dude. Make some noise for DJ Precision. You know, I've known this guy since he was like 16 years old. And after that, remember after the Black History Month thing, like towards the end of the semester, we did like a big performance. And Precision and I, we did like a duo thing on Peter Piper. Remember? Crazy, right? Yo, I'm proud of you, bro. Good shit, man. Love you too, man. Good shit, B. Word.
I was the man at school after that shit. Like, we did the performance, yeah. I was a quiet kid, and I did that. I went to school the next day. I was like, ah! I can't stand. Thank you, Rob. Thank you, Sinister. I wouldn't be standing here today if it wasn't for these guys. Like, real shit.
So it just goes to show, man, that there's more to what you guys see from myself and Mr. Sinister and Precision, he showcased earlier, and the four DJs that competed in tonight's DMC. There's so much more to this art form than us just up here showing off. Like this, there's a lot of meaning behind this art, and this art actually changes lives as well, man. So yeah, man, pretty dope. Enough of the mushy shit. I'm ready to get back into some hardcore shit, seeing you. Tampa, Florida, you?
Fucking tie you to a fucking bedpost with your ass cheeks spread out and shit, right? Put a hanger on a fucking stove and let that shit sit there for like a half hour. Take it off and stick it in your ass slow like,